Hey, why don't we talk to Charles, Dr. Charles Kimmelman?
Oh.
He is an acclaimed and board-certified otolaryngologist.
Oh, boy.
What's otolaryngologist?
You really know how to pronounce that?
Yes, I do. We'll let the doctor do it first.
No, it doesn't.
Dr. Charles P. Kimmelman.
Yes.
Welcome aboard, Doc.
Hello, sir.
How do you pronounce that very long word?
Otolaryngology.
That's what I thought. All right.
Otolaryngology.
Ear, nose, and throat.
Now,
do you do...
You think all those things would be connected for one guy to work on all three. Why all three?
Well, because they are connected.
Wow.
That's a very good thought. You're very, very insightful.
Wait, I have a question here.
Is he going to say you station tube at some point in this?
I have a feeling serious questions are going to start shortly. Are you located in New York?
I am.
Are you... I have very bad sinuses. I'm always stuffy. Do you do, like, the sinus reconstructions?
Yes, I do.
Are you good at it?
Yes.
You ever been sued?
Has any doctor ever been sued?
No.
Or me?
Yeah,
all doctors have been sued.
Yeah.
Is that a yes, then?
Yes.
Yeah.
Bunch of smart asses out there think they can make a quick buck is what it is.
That's right. Now, my thing is this. You said you can stop snoring. Now, I've heard of the surgery where you implant the little teeny tubes in back of somebody's throat, right? The soft palate?
Yes.
Is that the technical jargon there, teeny tubes?
Yes.
No, but it aptly describes it.
Yeah, it's a teeny
tube. They're like little cylinders made of a stiff Dacron-like material.
Now, someone's told me that was bad to put that foreign stuff in your body. Is that bad?
Well, it's pretty well tolerated. In fact, this kind of material has been used for 50 or 60 years for various reasons.
Really?
In other parts of the body, yeah.
Now, my friend was telling me that, like, what happens is when somebody is snoring, if there's an apnea situation, what you have to, because of a skin flap movement, if you're not going to get it fixed, then a sinus reconstruction, I mean, it's just got to kind of revolve around the whole thing.
Yeah.
Well, certainly the nose is involved in it, but it's not as major a role.
Who
as
the fuck booked this guy?
It's
not just the nose. What you're talking
not
about
just
is
the, nose,
the back
the throat.
Of the throat.
Exactly.
Yeah, that's where you snore from, really.
Exactly. That's where the sound comes.
So is it a
you're
big
doing them for free?
Lump of flesh back there flapping around that does it?
Right. The soft palate, the back part of the roof of the mouth where the uvula is, that little piece that hangs down and flutters.
Yes, the punching bag in cartoons.
Right, the punching bag.
Of course.
That's right. Cum stopper.
That plays a major role in generating the sound, but also the back part of the tongue and the side walls of the throat participate in this closure and relaxation. And that narrows the airway, and so the turbulence of air that results causes the fluttering and the flapping, just like the rapids in a river.
Well, like a lot of times, like if I'm like, how long does it take to take effect if you actually do that surgery? How long does it take to take effect?
Anywhere from a few weeks to a few months.
It takes that long for it to work?
Yeah, sometimes it does.
Like if I'm hanging out with my father and he's like, "Would give me like a Roman war helmet or something like that," I'm still gonna have trouble breathing.
Well,
my health doesn't allow it.
Yeah.
Well, for a short period of time, yeah.
Any
but,
type of
but
activity.
But eventually,
yeah.
If you put up with it, you will be rewarded.
Will you?
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, the hell. Yeah.
How long have you been doing these?
2 years.
Have you?
Yeah.
2 years, and yeah, you got a success record.
70-80%.
Do you?
What is it with like drinking? Because I know a lot of people either if they're fat or drink a lot. They get sleep apnea.
Exactly, that plays a big role during the deepest phase of sleep. All the muscles.
Someone
relax.
Wake me up when this horse shit
and
is
especially
done.
Especially in the throat, that can be affected and made a lot worse by alcohol.
By alcohol?
Alcohol.
Now, why is that?
Because the alcohol relaxes muscles.
Does it?
Ah, and then when the muscles are relaxed, the tissue that is being held by the muscles kind of loosens up.
Exactly, and collapses
flaps
and
around.
Closes off.
Does it?
I gotcha.
Yeah.
Wow. Now, what is this the bed partners of chronic snorers, overwhelmingly women, often bear the brunt and a higher risk of fatigue and even hearing loss?
Exactly.
Now, how is that possible?
Well, snoring can be pretty loud, and if you're right, your ear is right next to the person,
uh-huh.
It can affect you.
So you're saying if your ear is close to the person,
right?
That's
good
snoring.
It usually is. Unless you're sleeping at the foot of the bed or something.
Well, you wouldn't sleep at the foot of the bed or something, but I can understand how 69. The snoring, if your ear is closer to the person.
Right. And and some of these people snore so loud, the neighbors down the block hear them.
Do they?
And I never thought, I thought like other things, maybe music or something, but I never thought snoring into your ear would make any damage.
Well, you know, over a period of time it can. One night won't.
How many decibels is that when they snore that loud?
Good question.
I know above 90,
30, 50, 60 decibels.
And is it comparable? That's comparable to what type of maybe machinery or something else we could put in perspective?
Well, it's like turning your iPod up.
Oh. Is it?
Into your like full volume and just have that there.
Actually, I heard until you go above 85 decibels, it's okay.
Yeah, 85 is about right, I think.
Yeah, 85 for a
so if you're snoring at 50, that's really not a problem, is it?
Because I've heard when you put that iPod thing, the pods in your rear, and turn it up loud, you could do some damage.
Doctor, I do a lot of production. Right.
This is Steve now coming into the conversation.
Hi, I do a lot of production, my life partner, he snores rather loudly, and I think it's beginning to affect my hearing. What can I possibly do to stop that?
Sleep in a different room.
No. Can I?
That can't be possible.
No, but,
yes.
Maybe
if I sleep in the other room, there'll be no reach around.
They're attached at the hips.
Hey, Dr. Kimmelman.
Right.
We got an actual snore. I'm going to play a clip of someone snoring.
Okay.
You're not going to believe that this is actually someone snoring, but it is, and I want you to tell everybody what's going on here.
A professional opinion, maybe. Right. I know it's a little hard over the phone, but...
This, I swear to you, too, that you're not going to believe this is an actual snore, but it really is. Here we go.
Doctor, that's my point.
Have you ever heard anything like that?
Oh, yeah.
You have.
Sounds like a small animal rape.
Isn't that great? Yeah. It sounds like a velociraptor.
Yeah. What
how would you like to be with that all night?
No, not at all. You'd never sleep. The bed would be shaking.
Yeah.
Right.
Your liquor cabinet would be empty.
What can you tell us about that snore?
Well, that snore is near total obstruction. Not totally, because then there's no sound at all.
Near total obstruction. Let me ask you this question, sir. Can the lack of oxygen give somebody with a snore like that some type of brain damage?
Absolutely.
Wow.
Yeah, it can cause strokes, it can cause heart attacks, high blood pressure, all sorts of other metabolic dysfunction.
Can it cause maybe some type of damage to
the nervous system?
The brain, where maybe you wouldn't be attentive?
Exactly.
And maybe you'd shake a lot?
Perhaps, yeah.
Interesting. Almost total blockage.
Yep.
Oh. Hey, let's go to Bill in Arizona. He has a question for the boring doctor.
Hello, Bill.
Bill, what's up?
Hello, Bill.
Hey, gentlemen, how are you? I was hoping the doctor might be able to help. It's actually my wife who's the snorer.
Now, that's odd. Quickly, Bill. Now, doctor, many of the times it's men, correct?
Right, but also women snore.
Women do snore. Okay, right. Bill. Bill from Arizona, please continue.
Well, there is another issue, too. It is more based on her gag reflex.
Uh-huh.
And she has a terrible gag reflex. Now, I'm not a large individual, but she does gag quite frequently.
I don't know if this is the doctor's specialty over here.
No, it is. It's part of it.
But it must be part of it, a gag reflex.
Sure. Well, gag reflex.
It's deep in the throat, right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Well, my big question is that she usually gags, when she's snoring. So my question is, do I need to wake her up in order to have oral sex?
Oh, that's a good question.
It is a good question.
Wake her up to have oral sex?
Yeah. I don't think that's really his expertise.
I don't know. Right. He is a sleep apnea.
That's a little out of my field.
That is a little out of the
league. Are you saying that you kind of climb on?
He wasn't talking about penetration. He was talking about oral sex.
Now, I don't believe that that's
that's the only way I'm able to get her to stop snoring. I'm having trouble getting her to stop snoring, but that's one way. But she does gag.
To use her face like it's a piece of liver.
The procedure that we've been talking about would be an alternative.
Yes.
Well, that's true. What do they call that procedure?
Pillar procedure, because the little implants are pillars. They look like little
columns.
Yeah, to hold up the roof. Yeah.
Oh.
Mm-hmm.
I'm sorry. Was that kill her?
P P-I-L-L-A-R.
Because a friend of mine who lives in Modesto, I think he tried that procedure as well.
He actually, and that worked, for him, didn't it? Because his wife doesn't snore anymore.
Yeah. Right. His kid was snoring, too.
We all know the story. It's terrific.
Yeah, that stopped the snoring.
All right, well, I'm punching out. Thank you, good doctor, and...
Yeah. Wish we could.
Happy birthday.
So I'm glad, Doctor, you can, you know, go with some of those questions. Because with the callers, we never know what we're going to get over here.
Yeah.
Yeah, the spontaneity is good.
Yeah, but, you know, we want to pretty much stick to the sleep apnea problem here.
We try to have a medley of merriment.
Yes, exactly. Exactly.
Oh, boy. Doc? Doc?
Yeah.
Okay. Kevin's on the line from New York. Yes, Kevin.
Hi, Doctor. I just wanted to ask you, is it a very exciting job that you have? Because it sounds very, very exciting.
Kevin's asking if the job itself is exciting.
Is this Big Kev, by the way?
Because
a lot of Kevins call our show. I think this is Big Kev, yeah. Go ahead, Big Kev. Continue.
Well, it just seems like a very exciting job. Do you have any... interesting stories from this profession.
You mean from ear, nose, and throat in general?
Yes, it seems like one of the more exciting types of specialties.
Well, it is, because ear, nose, and throat is what makes you human, right? Our ability to communicate like we're doing now.
Oh!
Hearing, speaking, language.
What?
All of that is what we do.
Never thought of it that way, but I bet a foot doctor says... We couldn't walk if it wasn't for me.
That's right. I mean, what you're saying is that one doctor will say one thing, and yet podiatry will say another, and yet in another case, a chiropractor will say another, and yet somebody who probably specializes in other areas of the teeth, the dentist will say the other.
Chiropractor,
an ophthalmologist will say the other about the eyes. Like, without the eyes, we don't see each other.
Right.
Or maybe somebody else, like a chest doctor, would make that point with a chest or a
heart
specialist.
You're not going to live very long.
Cardiologist, perhaps, or somebody that might specialize in the liver and small intestines.
Right.
Gastroenterologist,
we all know that.
Something like that. Wow, okay.
But ear, nose, and throat, that's where it's at.
That's where it's at.
You're an ENT.
That's right.
That's like three things, though, to know.
Yeah.
Like, you know, you're a doctor. Yeah. Maybe you want to study the foot.
Or the colon and the fist.
Right. Big Kev is back. Big Kev.
Yeah, this is the real Big Kev. I'd like to ask the doctor, I was born without a sense of smell. Will I ever get it back?
That's very interesting, because there are very few people who do a lot of smell and taste work, and I'm one of them. Who does it? So that's another interesting
question. Big Kev can't smell, but he still loves junk food.
Wow.
Like, I don't get that, Big Kev.
I don't love junk food.
Well, you can't taste things either, right?
I can taste most things.
Yeah, but most of the flavor of food is both smell and taste, and of that, smell is the most important. But if he's never smelled since birth, then his body is focused on
the crunching sound of the Doritos.
Well, not only that.
Yesterday's segment left a bad taste in his mouth.
All there is to taste per se is sweet, sour, salty, and bitter. But the flavor of food is mostly smell. So he's developed highly his sense of gustation or taste, sweet, sour, salty, and bitter.
So he's like a superhero with a sense of taste.
Exactly.
So it's kind of really useless.
That's right. Like when he's asking questions, he can taste an interview dying in his mouth.
Good example.
Holy shit.
God damn, Kev.
Thank you.
By the way, sweet, sour, and salty, bitter are the tastes we usually
Holy
talk
shit,
about.
We don't know how to end this
crap. In the Japanese culture.
Yes,
they recognize
culture.
A lot of other ones, and one of them is umami. Umami.
That's like bukkake, right?
No, it's the taste of glutamate.
What's
monosodium glutamate?
Oh, that they put in their food.
Right. But it's a savory, you know, meaty kind of taste.
I thought we were all the same inside. How could another different race?
Right.
Well, you know, it's just a cultural thing. It's not that we can't taste it. But
well, you're saying they've been given the gift of the ability to taste something we can't, yet we have been given the gift of driving.
Right.
Well, Doc, do we have glutamates here?
Do we have glutamate?
Glutamates.
Yeah.
Oh, glutamate?
Right.
Yeah.
I don't know.
What that's called. What is that?
What
glutamate.
Is it?
Glutamates.
Which glutamate.
I thought you were a specialist.
Yeah.
Right. We have
glutamates.
Not only that, it's in your body. It's an amino acid that's also used by the brain to transmit electrical signals. Yeah.
Oh, my God, he's still talking.
So they're good for you.
Holy
They're good
shit.
For you, yeah.
If you put in ones like from Chinese food or something, do they go to the places that need to go to?
Yeah, but there's too much of it, and that's why you get a buzz.
Yeah, but a lot of doctors have come out and said that's a rumor, though, and it hasn't happened that way.
It's like a population problem.
Oh, this is a bit that's never going to end. It's not going to end good.
That's, no, that's great. This is informing a lot of people about a very serious problem that I don't think they look at as serious. Because as growing up, a lot of cartoons and shows have shown snoring as something humorous and funny.
Exactly.
And it's a very serious problem.
It can be a serious problem.
Like, you know, Reggie...
And now there's a solution.
I was saying something!
Jimmy?
Reggie White,
yeah. Reggie White died of it, right.
Wow.
He died of,
obstructive
I was
sleep
saying
apnea.
That! Jimmy! Sleep apnea.
Wow.
Be nice to our guest, Jimmy.
No, I am, but I'm trying to say something. Forget it, I won't talk.
Good. Jim, you're going to get suspended, man. You have to treat the guests a little
bit. Yes, I love the guests. I'm happy you're on the show, but I've had this problem, and I was the one that said I would like somebody to help clarify it.
You know what rhymes with snore?
Yes. Shore is
shore,
one thing.
Whore.
Door.
Door.
And
gore. Gore. Core. Lore.
So what's the procedure for making your sinuses bigger?
Snore.
Because I was having some difficulty sleeping.
Right.
And, you know...
It depends.
I'm not finished.
You have to evaluate the patient. Surgery like that is indicated in certain instances, but not in everybody.
I'm not done yet.
That's terrible. I'm sorry.
Making the openings between the sinuses and the nose larger, so the air enters the sinus cavity and the secretions exit it.
What are you doing in my house?
No, he's asking, do you make house calls?
Oh, in your house? No, not usually.
How long?
We have equipment.
I was trying to ask you something.
Okay. Go ahead.
Is it possible?
James?
Yeah. How long would it take to get it done?
To get what done? The sinus scale. Operation?
Yes.
The operation?
Yeah.
What's wrong, Jimmy?
I was trying to finish.
Okay.
Because it's hard to breathe. It's very hard for me to breathe a lot of the times.
Okay.
That's why we have you on the show today, Doc. Jimmy's very agitated because he's not sleeping at night and he has some kind of nasal problem.
AIDS. I think you should make an appointment right away.
Yeah. Where exactly? I want to see your. Where are you located? We'll definitely give you a good plug. Because I'm trying to ask you a question.
45 East 72nd Street, New York City.
Are you reputable?
I believe I am. Oh. Yes.
Tearing the ass out of me.
Do you have a website?
I have a website, www.stopsnoringnewyork.com.
Oh, I thought it was imabore.com.
Is it NY or New York?
No.
New York.
So stopsnoringnewyork.com.
Yes. You advertise on the subways?
Imabore.org. It's not even good enough to get the .com.
That's always a red flag. They got a website and stuff.
Yeah.
Like they're hyping a band. Mm. The guy's actually going to work on your nose.
You know, it's a way of getting
making
the information
money.
Out.
Is
it's the word out. It's the goddamn 2006. Everybody's on the internet.
Exactly.
Billy Burr.
He's paying for his yacht.
We don't need encyclopedias anymore.
Right.
The internet.
It's the future. Thank God this guy's in touch with the future. You go to some of these guys, they got volumes of books behind them. What the hell good are those?
Hey, Doc, what did you want to be when you were growing up?
A doctor.
Yeah?
What kind of doctor?
Well, I didn't really know. You know, I was willing to
A vagina doctor?
Yeah, did you ever do the gynecology?
Well, in medical school you do, but you know what?
Wow.
But that was icky, right?
You ever lose a ring?
Delivering babies were fine, but the other stuff wasn't.
Wait, why wouldn't you want to be a vagina doctor?
Why?
Well, yes, doctors this all the time. Like, if I'm going to be a doctor, I'm going to go for the vagina doctor.
Most of your patients are over 60.
Some inborn issue there that they have to deal with.
Yeah.
Well, do you think that the medical profession... has changed a lot recently because of litigation, lawsuits. Mm-hmm.
Absolutely.
And
it makes us...
All right, go ahead, you talk.
It has to, you know, have to worry about that all the time.
Doc, and, he wasn't done with his question.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. And who usually wins?
Yeah, there you go.
And who usually wins?
I don't know!
The insurance companies.
Right.
The lawyers, right?
Right.
Look, listen to me breathe.
Oh.
You know,
I'm not done breathing!
Wait, I want to finish.
Me too. Now you know how that hurts.
Is the process, you know, it's one-on-one.
Is it?
You know,
a lot of the nothing's benefit, wrong. Just stay in the living room. I'll handle it.
All right, Steve. Sorry.
A lot of the benefit is the doctor talking to the patient, going over, you know,
no.
to help, and that's what's changed.
No.
No, you're not agreeing, Steve?
That's terrible. I'm sorry.
He doesn't agree with you.
Okay. Well,
Steve
like
that, though. He's very, very disagreeable.
Get the fuck out now.
No, Steve. Back to production.
Are there certain foods that are more likely to cause, like, I have a very bad thing in the back of my throat where I'm always going, I always have to clear my throat. Is that tied in with my nasal drip? Like, I take Mucinex a lot.
Yes. Especially dairy products make that worse.
All right, you go ahead. I wasn't done, but go ahead.
Yeah, dairy products will make the saliva thicker. And give you more of a problem like that.
A lot of times I've got. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt my question. A lot of times I'll have coffee, and like I'm fine, and yet I'll have a cup of coffee, and the next thing you know, I got to take like two Mucinex, so I'm not like clear my throat every 10 seconds.
Yeah, do you have cream in the coffee?
What's that? Yeah, jump
do you have
right
cream
in.
Cream in the coffee?
No, I don't. I have fat free or lactaid.
Yeah, well that'll do it too.
All right, well Willis.
Yeah, so drink it black. See what happens.
I can't drink it black.
Okay.
I don't like it black. I'm trying to say, help me here, Hendry, if I want.
Well, why don't you drink Hawaiian Punch?
Nah, that does it too. There's certain beverages that just do it. But yeah. It really is like a problem for me. I always have a feeling I got this like thin trail of booger spit in the back of my throat. It drives
me nuts.
Oh, go ahead. Sorry, I didn't mean to ask
me tell
you something. You're right. You would know. You're the doctor.
All right. You're making fun of it, but mucus is good. We can't live without mucus.
No, I didn't say let's remove all mucus like it's in the Warsaw Ghetto in 1941. I was simply saying, how do I stop clearing my throat all the time?
Well,
I don't really know what to do about it. It's driving me nuts.
Mm-hmm.
And I'll take, like, Mucinex, which does clear it up. But
right.
I notice I have to take more and more and more, and I'm not sure. It drives me crazy. And I think it's tied into the fact that I have bad sinuses.
Well, it very well may be. I mean, I have to examine you to find out what other factors are playing a role. Do you drink a lot of water?
I do, actually. I drink probably more water than is good for me. That's what people have been telling me my whole life. I'm in the bathroom a lot, which I thought meant diabetes, but it turns out that it's just that I drink a lot of water.
Yeah,
right.
And I'm not too sure if that helped. It does help a little bit.
It does help.
But I like that.
And
certain, go ahead. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to just talk to you. All right, go ahead. Now, how do you diagnose me if we're both talking?
And then there are certain kinds of sprays that can be used in the nose to hydrate you better.
Yeah, can they?
Yeah.
Like
and,
what?
And if you're taking
sorry. Go ahead. Right away. What would you recommend spray-wise?
Something called Clear, X-L-E-A-R.
Queer?
Yes, spelled X-L-E-A-R. It is a saltwater spray with a sugar in it called xylitol. It cleans up the nose.
But I've tried, like, saline rinses and all that stuff.
Yeah, well, try the Clear.
What's that? I don't even know how to spell Clear.
X-L-E-A-R.
That's not how you spell Clear, and I'm never going to find that or remember it, and our listeners won't remember that. I mean, I'm trying to get help here. I tried steroids. They gave me steroids to shoot up my nose.
Nah, it's not going
to
happen.
That's what I'm trying to tell you, and all of a sudden, I'm the dummy.
Right.
They don't work, the steroids, and this Clear thing you're talking about.
You listen to me and get the Clear.
I tried that one time. The steroids are no good.
No, the Clear is not a steroid.
I don't care what the sexual orientation is. It's not important to me.
All right. Well, if you want to get better, you'll listen to me.
I am trying to listen to you, but you won't let me get a word in. You keep interrupting me, and I'm trying to tell you my problems.
Okay.
I can't breathe at night. I have stuffy noses.
Mm-hmm.
And I snore, and it's bothering me.
Well, come on in and we'll take care of it.
And that's the answer for everything, isn't it?
Well, it's an answer for you.
It's not an answer for me. I need help now. What kind of spray can I buy?
I just told you.
I don't have steroids.
No. It's not steroids. All right. I love being the butt of the joke.
No, you know, we're having a good time with you, but I really do have...
Yeah.
Serious. I do actually have very bad sinuses, and I actually do have a very bad throat.
Yeah, let's...
So you're saying like sprays probably aren't that good.
Right. But for some, you know...
What type would be the best?
Well, for what condition? For what he has?
Yes.
Yeah.
Something that moistens and hydrates the nose, makes it wetter.
My health doesn't allow it.
Really?
Yeah.
I guess.
It's a health problem.
Yeah.
You know, my wife used to...
No, she's dead!
Used to take sprays.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Good evening.
Chris in Jersey has a question for the good doctor. Chris?
Yeah.
Hey, Chris. You're on with the doctor.
I had a question for the doctor. I have a very irregular snore. It started up ever since I was a kid. I was at a particular sleepover. We were up in a treehouse, and my friend asked me if he would, he could do oral treats for me. And ever since then, I've had this very strange snort. Cheep, 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 cheep. I was wondering if the doctor, could help me with that.
It goes like, let me see if I can get it right. I might have more of a handle on it.
You probably are more familiar with it.
You're talking about. It's like.
That's exactly what it's like, yeah.
Okay.
Oh, that's a good question, Chris. Thank you.
You ever hear a snore like that? Because there's so many different types of snores.
Yeah. That sounds like Popeye.
Please say.
Food, all right.
Yeah.
But, the pillar procedure.
Would you address the question?
Yeah, we got the joke. It sounds like Popeye, but the guy was very serious Doc.
No, I know. I mean, it's something that that the pillar procedure would be.
What do pillows have to do with this?
Killer again?
Well, because it stabilizes the palate.
That's not. I heard that's a rumor.
That happening.
Jews.
Hmm?
Yeah, I heard. He said it was a rumor.
A rumor. It's true.
Once you drink juice, it. Something happened.
All right, we got Jimmy Robinson that wants to ask a question. Jimmy Robinson, where are you calling from?
I'm calling from Long Island.
All right, Jimmy. You got a question for the doctor?
Yes, doctor. Sometimes I have some really bloody thick mucus when I wake up with my snoring at night. Someone told me about lighting a Java log and sleeping with that. Do you think that maybe that's making it like...
Good question. Doc?
I'm sorry. What did he say? Lighting a what?
Java log.
Java log.
What's that?
Yeah, I'm lighting a Java log. It's like a manufactured chemical log that you put in your fireplace. Mm-hmm. And I'm not sure if maybe the blood is...
Oh. Well, yeah, those...
Wait.
You know, that might be irritating.
Hold on.
Yeah.
Yeah, let's...
Huh.
I have... Do you think?
And also, now that we got that out of the way, do we think that maybe my sleep would be increased with the help? You know, boom.
With the I'm sorry, I missed that.
Is it possible?
Yeah, Jimmy will explain.
If you're snoring, just take something before bed.
Wow.
That will make you not snore as much.
Doc?
I didn't hear it.
Wow, you might want to look into your own ears.
Ironic.
Just enjoying a banana.
Can you look into your own ears? Do you do that?
Yeah, you can. We have a special fiber optic instrument. That
is that because you don't trust other doctors?
Well, no, I mean...
come on, there's a lot of hacks out there.
Who would want anyone else poking around in the ear?
Yeah, that's true.
But, if you wanted to look in your own ear, you can do it. Put it on TV camera and see it.
How many women do you usually get coming in?
For snoring?
Yeah.
About 5% of them are women.
Now, do you
that doesn't mean that there's
sorry,
5%.
I didn't ask the question, but you go right ahead with the dissertation.
That doesn't mean there's only 5%.
Sorry, yeah, I didn't mean
to
actually host a radio show.
Yeah.
Feel free. Do they pay or do they have insurance?
Who?
The
women.
Oh, I don't know. Maybe if we were talking and listening and not talking, we would know the questions.
No, they have both. They pay or
the women
have
pay. Do you notice if the women that pay are of a better caliber than the women that have insurance?
That's an interesting question.
Money-wise.
Yeah, usually they're more affluent.
God damn it!
Yeah. Let's go to Travis in Oklahoma City. Travis, you got a question for the good doctor.
Is this Dr. Kimmelman?
Yes.
Yeah.
Dr. Kimmelman, my doctor was recommending that I come see you. That's so weird that you're on my favorite radio station. My doctor, Sparks, told me that I needed to come see you, and I just had a quick question. I was wondering, when you do this procedure, if you've ever stuck in somebody's mouth?
I'm guessing an instrument.
Travis, could you say that again, please? I don't think the doctor... Doc, did you hear that?
No.
Yeah, Travis, if you will, again.
Yeah, don't lean...
I'm sorry. I was just wondering, when you do this procedure, do you ever stick your cock in your customer's mouth?
Now, dump what? That. I'm dumping out of that right now.
Make sure that doesn't go out.
Callers get through the screen.
What are you saying that? What is that? I mean...
And, Why don't we talk to, I know we got another guy here that wants to get in on this. Frank the Frowner's got a big problem. He's got some kind of a mouth. Your work.
Doctor!
Here's Frank the Frowner, Doc.
Doctor!
Yes?
I have a problem with my lips. I always look like I'm frowning, no matter how happy I am on the inside.
You're sorry?
No! Pay attention to me! I say I always look like I'm frowning.
Frowning.
Regardless of how happy I am on the inside. And I was wondering if there was anything that could be done to my facial tissue.
Well...
Do you know it takes more muscles to frown than it does to smile? I was once told by an older Negro who was forcing himself down my throat.
Now, Doctor, is that true? We've heard that for years, that it takes more muscles to frown than it does to smile. Is this just a urban myth?
Is that true or is it a misnomer?
Yes.
Because I've always wondered.
It does.
It's a myth. Yeah.
Wow. So how many muscles does it take?
32.
To do what? You're not clarifying. You're just yelling numbers.
All right, Frank.
Frank, calm down a little bit. Please don't be mean to our guest.
Well, that's one of the another aspect of being human, the ability to have facial expression.
That's the problem. Work. My mother, I had fetal alcohol syndrome. She drank a lot, and my father practiced judo on her belly.
And that caused the problem with it makes him look like he's frowning all the time. You ever hear of that?
No.
Wow.
All right, let's go to Nick in Wyoming. Nick?
Yes, hi, guys. I'd like to speak to the doctor, please.
All right, Dr. Charles you're on. Kimmelman.
Yes.
Doc, how are you? Listen, every night before I go to bed, I drink a couple of drinks. I drink bikini teenies mostly. And me and the boys in Wyoming, in the mountains, we love to drink bikini teenies. Would that affect my throat? Because I have a problem breathing at night then.
Yes, it would.
Mm.
It'll make you more likely to snore.
And why is that, Doc?
Because it relaxes the muscles during the deepest phase of sleep excessively, and that allows the throat to close off, and that causes the snoring.
Ooh, yeah. So should I give up the bikini teenies? Is it the bikini teenies in particular, or maybe is it? Should I drink maybe coffee, or what should I do? I like the alcohol, but bikini teenies are my choice.
That's a tough one.
Don't drink late at night, otherwise you're going to snore.
Wow.
Okay, Doc. Thanks for your help.
You're welcome.
That's great advice we could have got from a 10-year-old.
I'm getting an instant feedback question here. It's from Modesto, California. This guy's saying that his wife is pregnant and she started snoring to the point where he can't even take it anymore.
Exactly.
Do pregnant women snore?
Yes, they're more likely to snore because of the extra weight and fluid they have during that.
Is that grounds for an abortion?
Yeah.
Is that what?
Grounds for an abortion.
Well,
No.
I think you should,
temporary.
Maybe find a different way around that.
Oh, okay.
But extra weight, that might help him out in the second part of his question that I'm reading. Okay.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Would you say that what percentage of people with apnea who have not had any type of reconstructive surgery, would you say?
Yeah. Oh my God, this is never going to end. Holy shit. We don't know what end is. Usually we have a big finish. Instead, we're all snoring our asses off.
But how about...
This guy stinks.
No.
This guy stinks on ice. Holy shit.
Do you think he's still listening?
Oh my God.
Is anybody there?
Hello?
Yeah.
Hello?
Did you finish your question?
Hello?
I guess everybody fell asleep.
Now, my question was about the percentage of people who have an apnea.
Yeah?
Who have never had any type of reconstructive surgery.
Go ahead. Go on. Leave. I pardon you.
My question is, are those people less likely or more likely to enjoy a full health if...
If what?
Right. If, please don't avoid the question. Please address this head on.
Please what?
Address this question head on.
You didn't finish it.
I did.
I didn't hear it. Can you repeat it?
Once no. again, you gotta get your ears checked.
No, he can't, repeat it.
Do you know what it sounds like? My girlfriend snores a lot, which is really annoying.
We've done it. I think the mission's complete. We put our entire audience to sleep.
Yeah. I just want to say one last thing.
Yes?
Only if the doctor's listening.
Yes?
Yes, doctor.
Here I am. I'm waiting.
Yes!
Whatever happened to the days of Fraser Crane?
Huh?
Shut up!
Remember he used to say, I'm listening?
By the way, you know, when you're telling these little stories, here's a good idea. Have a point. It makes it so much more interesting for the listener.
I'm not sure what you mean. Fraser Crane how? It was Kelsey Grammer. What are you talking about?
He allegedly because it was in Seattle.
Oh, it was what?
Yeah, he was in Seattle.
Well, he allegedly hooked up with his 13-year-old babysitter when he was here in Jersey.
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
Yeah, we all know that.
Do you align yourself with those kinds of behavior?
No.
What's your website again?
Sucks.
What is it? StopSnoringNewYork.com?
Yes.
Stop whining.
Hold on a minute.
Any like final statements about this? Because it is actually a very serious subject.
It is a serious subject.
Yeah,
and I think people all know that there's a way to, you know, treat it.
Yeah,
so
Doc,
that we don't have to bother everybody.
Doc, we had some fun with you, but please, give it the big plug here and give it the big,
Yeah, this is something that really is much better than the older treatments, and it really avoids hospitalization, cutting, stitches, general anesthesia, and it's something that people ought to be aware of and look into if it's appropriate for them. And it is a new technique that people have not heard about enough, and that's why we're here at trying to let people know about it.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. Serious issue with health concerns in terms of, as we mentioned, high blood pressure, heart disease, stroke, problems with attention, falling asleep all the time. Mm-hmm. It can change your life if this problem is corrected. And it involves a large percentage of the population. Upwards of half the population snores, and a significant number of people have sleep apnea. They may not even realize it. So if that is applicable to any of your listeners, you know, tell them to check the website and give me a call if they want. Anybody else have any questions? Hello? I hope I haven't put everybody to sleep. Switching gears, who would like to talk about voice? How about hearing? How about lumps in the neck? Well, this is the most animated interview I've ever given, I must say. Is anybody there?
That guy should have hung up like fucking 2 hours ago.
Oh my God, I've never seen so many pissed off people in my life on instant feedback. Oh, are they angry? Go fuck yourselves. Sometimes it's just about us.
It was interesting and it was really good. And
oh, wow. And he hung
and
in there.
And it might have went a little too long. What can I tell you?
He hung in there like a trooper.
All right, we'll continue with these men.
Ah, let's get the energy back in the show. John in Jersey, what do you have for the program?
I don't understand how anybody can think that that was bad radio. I was cringing so hard I got a hernia.
Yeah.
That was so uncomfortable, yet I couldn't tell anything.
Well, here's the deal. Anthony was saying it during the break. People either really, really, really loved the last hour of radio, or they hated it. There was no real in-between there.
Yeah, no in-between.
I enjoyed it myself there. It was fun.
I mean, and those guys, can, doctors can be such, like, dismissive pricks because I deal with them with my job. And I couldn't even help but feel sorry for the guy.
Right.
And he's just hung in there so long. It was just ridiculous.
I think Jimmy's new character alone.
Mm-hmm.
Interrupted guy.
Yeah, yeah.
Angry interrupted guy.
Just
the fact that that was born out of that nasty mess is well worth it. All right. Hysterical.
In fact, the family got in. It was just complete radio.
The problem is the doctor hung in there way too long. Because,
yeah.
You know, we don't want to fake it. We were waiting for the guy to hang up, and it took forever.
I was like fucking Rocky.
Yeah. I liked him, actually.
It wouldn't go down. All right, John. Thank you.